Hello, welcome back. You're watching the news, an extended bulletin in light of the president's address earlier today, in which he spoke on a range of issues of national interest. I'm Chris Higenyi, and a warm welcome to those who are coming on board right now. Let's now go into the details of what the president has been speaking about, including the latest on the developments in the COVID-19 vaccination process.
Museveni, in his State of the Nation address this evening, began by appreciating health workers who he said have been effective in the fight against COVID-19 since Uganda registered her first case.
We have succeeded. In other countries, they have lost a lot of people. I think as I speak, more than 2 million people have died in the world. Here, because you listened to our advice, in the last 12 months, we have had 40,581 people infected by this virus. 12,313 have recovered and been discharged. The ones who have died are only 334. This is a big success for which we need to congratulate ourselves.
The president also noted that to date, Uganda only has 24 patients in the entire country still hospitalized with COVID-19.
Why were the people who got infected few? Because we took very seriously. So therefore, those who were opposing these measures are really your enemies. I'm glad you didn't listen to them. You listened to our advice and you can see the results. As I speak today, in the whole of Uganda, we have got only 24 corona patients in the hospitals, in the whole country, just 24. So I congratulate you on this success, because it was our success, all of us.
Blame the recklessness of some Ugandans, which saw prominent people die as the country fought against COVID. The president also emphasized the need for vaccination, noting that even if him and the first lady have not vaccinated yet, Ugandans should go ahead, as this is only aimed at bettering and keeping the immune system strong.
We are going to buy more doses of that, and vaccinations have started. Up to now, 1,215 people have been vaccinated. I have not yet been vaccinated, nor has Janet. This is because we wanted to start with the people who are at high risk. These are the people who are working in hospitals.
He also disclosed that government is to embark on developing of vaccines to ensure that they don't import more moving forward.
So we have not yet been vaccinated. I'm also making my people look at all these vaccines. The one of Oxford, the one of the Chinese, the one of the Russians. We are also developing ours. We're developing our vaccine. We delayed a bit because, first of all, we had to struggle with our own slaves here who don't believe that we should be self-sufficient, shall make our own vaccine, and our vaccine will be better than some of these vaccines, because our children are working on the new virus, because this virus has been mutating.
The president also called upon Ugandans to continue observing standard operating procedures as the country is almost defeating COVID-19.
Therefore, on corona, I want to congratulate you for listening to our advice, and we can see. But in the meantime, please keep on wearing your masks. Observe the SOPs, standard operating procedures, until you have got, if you have started with this vaccine of Oxford, you need two, not one. So don't relax until you have got the full dose.
On the claims by the former National Unity Platform Party President Bobi Wine that he won with 3 million votes not counted, the president considered them stuffed ballots that were used by the opposition to tarnish the name of the ruling party.
On the contrary, it is the opposition, especially this group of Chagulany, which cheated massively. Everybody in Uganda knows who cheated. It was the Chagulany's group. Those votes which they are talking about, 3 point something million, those are not there. It was ballot stuffing massively here in Kampala, in other parts of the country.
The president also justified why there has been heavy deployment across the country in recent weeks.
So all those policemen who did not do their duty, we shall go for them. They will be held accountable, because they are the ones actually who were inciting these lawbreakers, thinking that they can break the law with impunity. That's why we had eventually to bring in the army to crush this criminality which has been going on.
In the meantime, the president warned those of the opposition who have been claiming that they will stop the swearing-in that security operatives will deal with them as their efforts are deemed illegal.